Hi, Ali from Ali Stitch Fingers here. Today I'm going to show you how to make the Totally Tote bag. This is a bag made out of faux leather. It's got quite a few different parts to it. We've got this lovely little tassel here to finish it off. Now, as you can see, this one has got some applique on the front. That's done with one of the Ali Stitch Fingers quilting rulers. We're not going to be doing that today, but we are going to make it with the magnetic clasps, and we have clasps at the side to make the bag smaller or larger. Inside we have a detachable makeup bag or safety bag, whatever you want to use it for, which has got a nice zip. And then we also have a little humbug purse as well. If I don't get time to make these two components, I will do a separate video afterwards. But first of all, we're going to show you how to make up the bag. So to start, I've actually put some interfacing just on the top parts of the panels down the side and on the front and back. That's just iron on interfacing. So you'll notice that I'm actually doing this wrong sides together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew 1 centimeter seam across the base. So we have the two sides and the base, and this is what's going to make up the gusset of the bag. I'm just going to sew straight across. Take it out. Now I am using an industrial machine purely for speed. When you've seen this one on the TV, it's been done with just a domestic sewing machine, so don't think you need to have one of these to do it. I'm sewing another row of stitches just to the side of that, and then I'm going to take it out and just trim pretty close to those stitches. And this is going to make it look like a proper leather bag. So now what we're going to do is take one of the side pieces, one of the front or backs, and I know which way it goes because I've done the interfacing on there. So I'm going to lay that down and take one of the gusset pieces, put them wrong sides together, and then we're going to do exactly the same all the way around. So about a 1 centimeter seam. Do a couple of locking stitches. If you want to pin, I would recommend using these little clips rather than pins. You can pin in the seam allowance, but these just make it easier. So I'm going to stitch down and stop about a centimeter from the bottom. So when we get to this bottom bit, I'm going to stop with my needle down, and I'm going to pull the bag front or back, whichever you're using, around to line up with the base here. I'm going to just straighten that up, put the foot down and continue sewing. Just make sure that you move all this out of the way underneath. So basically you're just pivoting at that corner there. Exactly the same here, hold it together. Stitch so you're about a centimeter away. You can actually feel the seam underneath where you need to stop, because it's actually on the seam underneath on the gusset. Pull it around, line up these sides here, make sure you move all the bits from underneath, and then continue stitching up the side. You will take a lot more time than me, but I need to get this video done. Take that out and then repeat with another row of stitches just to the side of those. So I'm going to do this pretty quick because you've seen it all before. If you have a walking foot for your machine, I would recommend using it. It just makes both layers feed at the same time. I also recommend taking a little bit more time than me. So I just stop at the side of those stitches. Make sure you tuck everything away underneath and continue around. Now you would trim all this off, and I'll just start to do it so you can see. So just to the side of the stitches, all the way around. Obviously I'm not going to do it all, but that's what you need to do. Now I need to do it on the other side, so I'm going to turn that over, put that under my machine and get my other piece, make sure the interface is to the top, and do exactly the same. So I'm going to do this one a bit quicker. Stitch down to the bottom. You can see how mine's pushing it off. If you've got a walking foot, it'll help with that. Bring it around, line up these sides here. Same on this side, hold the corner. You can see how wobbly it is, but it doesn't matter because I'm going to straighten that off when I actually cut off all the excess. Stop with your needle down. Now I am doing this too quick, so you can see I have got a bit of excess there, but it's not going to make any difference to the bag. You would do your other row of stitches. I'm gonna skip that part. Right, so that basically is the body of your bag. If you was doing anything on here, you would actually do it before you put it all together. I'm just gonna show you how to put the magnetic clasps in, and I'm just gonna show you on one. Right, so your magnetic clasps come in four pieces. You have the female part here, the thicker one at the base, but it's the female part, the male part, and these little rings here. How these work, is we're going to put them two and two. So you need to put one at one side, and how I do it, I just leave a little indent into there. You can just see those little indents. Take a pair of scissors or a unpicker. Let's see if I can do it so you can actually see. I'm just going to punch her. I need to do it so my arms twist. That's it. Just a tiny little snip, just so you can get those prongs through. Now you'll be able to move yours into whatever position you want. So those prongs come through the back, pop the piece on the back there, and either open it out or close it in. It really doesn't matter which way you do it, so long as it's secure. And that is your clasp there. Now for the other side, how I do it is I put the female part in, close it up so that it's all lined up, and then just press on the back. And then I can see where I need to put my other prongs in there. So I will quickly do this one just so you can see again. Still see the prong marks there. And there. Just tiny little snips. Take that back off that one and push that through. Now that's the way you do it for all of them. There is seven on this, but obviously I'm not going to show you how to do the rest of them. So push that through. Turn it to the inside, put the back piece on, and then open out the legs on there. So now you can see you've got your two pieces, they fit together like that. You would trim off all this excess here, but you've got your magnetic clasps on that. Right, so the next part of the bag is the handle. I'm going to move that to one side, and for the handle I've got one that I finished here. You can make these as long or as short as you like. So that's personal choice. How we do it, we've got the strip, we fold one side in and the other side in about a centimetre and fold it over so there's no raw edges. So just take one of the little clips and clip that on. So we're going to work the whole way down here, one side in, fold it together, and then just put a clip on. Just one more here, just hold it all. Put a little clip on. So now what I'm going to do is top stitch all the way down both sides of that. Take the clips off as you go. The clips will leave marks on your faux leather, especially if you leave it overnight or something, but they will come out. It's quite forgiving. All the way down to the other end, go across the base and then back up the other side. Now if you wanted to, you could do two rows of stitches on this just for decorative effect. And that is your handle straps ready. Right, so we need to put those into the bag now. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to trim off a bit of excess there. And I'm going to measure about 4 inches from the side there, so that's about there. I'm going to put a clip, and then the same on this side, and put a clip, and then we need to make sure that the straps are going to go onto that piece there. Just clip one on and just hold it down and then turn it around so that you haven't got any twists in your handle. So you've got those clipped on there, and we're going to stitch across the top to hold them, and then do the same on the other side. So stitch about a centimetre from the top, and now this is going to take hold the weight of whatever's going to be held in that bag. So I would actually go across and back, and maybe even across again. And then the same on this one. Just for added security. Now I'm going to do the strap. Come off. There it is. On the other side, and I'm just going to line those up with the ones we've just stitched. There. You would take a lot more time than this. But I know you can pause me for whatever length you need to get to the same stage. Again, take off the pegs and across, You'll notice I've not done them on top of each other. I don't want to put too many holes in the handles to weaken the faux leather, so I'm actually moving the stitches to the side. So I'm going to go across there, reverse it by moving up slightly, can you see there, just about a couple of millimeters, and then going back over the top so the stitches aren't all on top of each other. Right, so that is the outer bag done, apart from all the cutting of the edges. But I'm just going to snip down about a couple of inches so that I can do the top stitching. You would go all the way around. Right, so I'll put that to one side now while I do some other little bits. So we've got the lining, and I need to do the tassel. So the tassel is basically the square of faux leather that I mentioned in the instructions, and we're going to put a line across and trim up to that line, so you've got that lovely little tassel there. And then you cut the strip to the measurements, and we're just going to fold that in half and stitch quite close to the fold side. All the way down. Slip off the excess. And then stitch again just to the side of that, either side, whichever you like the look of. Again, we've done it right sides together, and when I trim that off, it will just look like a thin leather strap. You could do this with scissors or a rotary cutter, but that's giving me a little thin leather strap to put onto the little tassel. So now what we need to do is get some glue. I'm going to put a thin layer on here and some on there. Put the top on before it goes everywhere. And we need to put it around the handle on here. So I'm just going to thread it around the handle and then put. Those two pieces together. Lay that onto one end and then just start to roll it around. I might have put a little bit too much glue on this. Roll it around. I'm just going to use one of my clips to get rid of some of this. Sort that out afterwards. So roll that around there and then clip. Might be a little bit big. There we go. To just let that dry. And there you've got your tassel attached to your handle. You don't have to put that on if you don't want to, but it does make a nice little finish to the bag. Right, so the lining, I've actually done this beforehand, it's done in exactly the same way as the outer bag, apart from we've got right sides together and we've done a centimetre seam. We don't have to trim this because we need to keep that to the side. Now I've made an opening gap down one of the sides, and I've also added a thin strap to put the humbug purse on. I will be showing that in the video with the humbug purse. So what we need to do now is put the bag inside the lining, so we have right sides together. So I'm just gonna hold that all together, pop it inside, open it out so that the pieces all line up undo the magnetic clasps. You would put all the clasps on as I tell you in the instructions, and we're just going to clip those two seams together there. Line up the seams on this side here and clip, and then exactly the same on this side. Line them up. And then we're going to stitch all the way around, catching in those handles as we go. So about a 1 centimetre seam again. Just pull that to the top there, line up those edges. Sorry for putting my hand in the way. Pull it taut as you go in. Take your clips off as you get to them. Oops, moved it then. Just get back online. Around the other side, just making sure it's all nice and straight. Back around to this side. Clips off as you get to them. Back around to where you started. Because we left that turning gap, we know that we can turn it that way. There we go. Take it out. And then we need to put our hand inside the turning gap there and pull the bag through. Just be careful when you get to that tassel that you don't undo the glue and the clip. So pull that through there. And your bag is almost finished. We just need to top stitch around the top. But I don't think you need to see me do that, so I will just show you. So we need to tuck everything to the inside now, get the lining in. And what you would be doing, and I'm just going to clip it here, because I do have to get my hand inside to put all those magnetic clasps. You would be doing it as you go. And here, the way around. This is why we put the clasps down here, so that when you top stitch, you're not going to get onto those metal pieces. There we go. Just a couple more so you can see what it's going to look like. And another one on here. Nice blue fabric inside this one. Right, so you can see now when you've top stitched and you put your clasps together, you're going to top stitch all the way around here. That is your Totally Tote bag. I'm going to do another video afterwards showing you how to do the little humbug purse and how to do the removable little pouch for the inside as well.